Can type 2 diabetics eat fruits? On the one hand, fruits have sugar. On the other hand, they also have lots of vitamins, minerals, and fiber. So what should type 2 diabetics do? Let's look at the research to answer that. In this video, I'm going to share 3 studies. But before we jump in, who am I to even be talking about this? My name is Igor. I'm the author of the Amazon best-selling book called Type 2 Diabetes Reversal Secrets. As well, I run an online personal training company called Fitness Solutions Plus that specializes in helping type 2 diabetics reverse their diabetes using exercise and nutrition. So let's jump in. In the first study that we're going to talk about, type 2 diabetics were divided into 2 groups. They were either given dates or they were given raisins. Both groups ate 60 grams per day, either dates or raisins, in addition to the regular diet. The duration of the study was 3 months or 12 weeks. At the end of the study, there were no changes in anything. There wasn't an improvement and there wasn't a worsening, either in A1C, in fasting glucose, in cholesterol, triglycerides, inflammation, nothing changed. In other words, there was no deleterious or negative effect of fruits on type 2 diabetics. So that's pretty cool. In a different study, 63 type 2 diabetics were divided into 2 different groups. There was the low fruit group and there was the high fruit group. The low fruit group consumed 51 grams of fruits per day. The high fruit group consumed 125 grams of fruits per day. And again, this also lasted 12 weeks. And the reason all these studies last 12 weeks is because that's how long it takes to change HbA1c or glycated hemoglobin. What happened at the end of the study? Both groups lowered their HbA1c by about 0.19%. In other words, there was no difference between the high fruit group and the low fruit group. So there was no deleterious effect. In fact, there was a slight positive effect. A reduction of 0.2% is not what you'd consider terribly effective, but it's nice to see there was a mild positive effect of fruits as opposed to a mild or a significant negative effect from fruits. So that's pretty interesting as well. Lastly, just so that I'm not accused of cherry-picking research, let's look at a meta-analysis. What is a meta-analysis? A meta-analysis is a type of study that looks at every study available on fruits, dried fruits, and blood sugar control in type 2 diabetics. So it's not like I'm picking studies that support my viewpoint. I'm picking studies that get results from my clients. I personally have no bias. I'm not interested in being right or wrong. I'm interested in the help of my clients. And so whatever the science says, that's what I go with. So in one meta-analysis that combined a number of studies that included 888 people eating either fresh fruits or dried fruits for 12 weeks or more, and most of those studies, on average, saw an improvement actually in blood sugar by about 0.17%, and this is A1C. Not a significant improvement, but what it shows is that fruits, including dried fruits, do not worsen type 2 diabetes, and in some cases make it ever so slightly better. So that's very interesting. And what are the mechanisms behind that? I mean, fruits are sweet. Shouldn't they raise blood sugar? Shouldn't they worsen diabetes? Why, in fact, does theory not match up with practice? What are the mechanisms behind this? Well, there are 2 reasons why fruits don't have a negative effect on blood sugar levels. Reason number 1 is, yes, there is sugar in fruits. But when somebody uses that as their only rationale, it shows a lack of understanding of what sugar really is. Sugar is actually 3 simple molecules. 1 is glucose, like blood glucose or blood sugar. 2 is fructose, just like what you find in primarily fruits, honey, maple syrup, agave nectar, and so on. And the last one is galactose, largely found in milk. Glucose, unsurprisingly, raises blood sugar the most and the fastest. Fructose does not raise blood sugar either to the same extent or with the same speed as glucose. And the primary sugar in fruits is fructose, not glucose. That's reason number 1. Reason number 2 why fruits don't really worsen blood sugar and make it ever so slightly better, even in diabetics, is because, yes, they're high in fructose, a sugar, however, they're also high in fiber. As I talked about in my other videos, linked in the description below, the second most impactful nutritional factor when it comes to blood sugar control is actually fiber. The first is total calories, and the third is total carbohydrates. And so by normalizing fiber levels, which is somewhere around 17 grams per 1,000 calories for diabetics, HbA1c has the potential to reduce by about 2.5% over a 3-month period or more. And especially dried fruits are very high sources of fiber, but even fresh fruits are decent sources of fiber. For those two reasons, that's why fruits, including dried fruits, are perfectly fine for diabetics with no limitations, as long as you don't go over your total caloric allotment. If you like this video, click like and subscribe. It will help you learn more good information when I publish more videos about type 2 diabetes, and it will help other type 2 diabetics learn the correct nutritional approaches to diabetes. Thank you and goodbye.